I'm Nika Chung, welcome back to my channel. HBO Max dropped their latest sci-fi thriller film, Reminiscence, directed by Lisa Joy. This is one of her first feature films and it's starring Hugh Jackman, Rebecca Ferguson, Thandiwe Newton, Daniel Wu, and Cliff Curtis. In the near future, climate change has caused seas to rise and flood Miami. Extreme daytime temperatures have forced most people to live at night. Nick Bannister, a private investigator, along with his friend, fellow veteran Emily Watts Sanders, operate a unique business that allows people to relive specific memories of the mind, navigates alluring world of the past. Very interesting. Watts operates this equipment while Nick provides psychological prompts to help the clients. One day, a walk-in client, May, arrives asking for his help in finding her missing keys. Nick is instantly attracted to her and the next night visits the club where she works as a waitress and singer. May makes a big impression on him when she happens to sing his favorite song. Nick and May begin a relationship and Watts is not really feeling this. She does not trust her. She's very sneaky and mysterious. Honestly, like, who would date their client? Nick's life turned upside down by this new client, May. A simple case becomes an obsession after she disappears and he fights to learn the truth about her, whether if it's good or bad. I dive right into this film like entering the rabbit hole with no expectations. I did not watch any trailers, but I definitely enjoyed this movie. The storyline was unique and engaging. I enjoyed the simplicity that it was demonstrated in the storytelling. It was easy to follow what was happening, even during the more complex reveals. It's suspenseful. He went further down the rabbit hole. Although May betrayed him by stealing from him, he was eager to find out what happened to May, the woman he was close to, and why did she take important classified info. Seriously, this jazz singer has the guts. She clad to a spectacular, lovely, chrysanthemum red gown that could disarm and stop a man at his tracks. This is an outfit Jessica Rabbit would wear. You know, wearing an outfit like that, you up to no good. Seriously, if I had the opportunity, I would definitely wear this outfit, but I would have to make sure I have a zero carb diet. Seriously, it's a lovely dress, I love it. Reminisce claims to establish about how human mind makes and stores memories. If May hasn't paid attention to the moment when she lost the keys and can't recall whereabouts of her keys, how could a memory of exist in her mind? And seriously, shouldn't this suspicious request alarm Nick Bannister at once? Honestly, it should've, but he was so into her. Hey, love is blind. May disappears into thin air months later, leaving Nick and Watts with nothing but a handful of clues and memories they can hold onto in order to stay afloat in their sunken maze of bigwig criminals, corrupt cops, and barons who mapped out their survival on the dry land. And on top of that, they cracked a few cases along the way. I'm glad Elsa's son, Freddy, was safe. Sebastian is a horrible person. He is so greedy. When I first saw him, I knew something was up. There was something off about this kid. Like, he was so quiet and so cautious. And his mother was acting really strange too. So I definitely knew something was up. Especially she's like role playing the same thing again, and like, yeah, that was kind of weird. Rebecca Ferguson's character May is mysterious. I don't know if she's a thief, Nick's friend, or a druggie strung out emotions, but one thing I can say is when May spoke to Nick Bannister through Cyrus, anticipating in his own dream, seriously, that surprised me. She was a clairvoyant and a presence of mind to do that, an absolute asset to any FBI, special forces, and the government. The character of Emily Sanders, played by the talented Thandiwe Newton, is well drawn, lots of depth. Thandiwe was wise and somehow able to save her character and its arc from the treacherous grasp of the writer and director. Thandiwe is a solid actress and the film scores a win because they casted her. She brought a lot of excitement to her character, and her daughter made a cameo in the film. Her daughter looks so much like her mom, she is tall. Very talented actress, I remember her in the Dumbo film, she was great. She's definitely an up-and-coming rising star indeed. Cliff Curtis is such a solid actor who can play any character, definitely an Anglo-Saxon. He does look like one too. And I will say, I find this heart-wrenching to watch who played in films such as Training Day, Sunshine, and Dr. Sleep being reduced to a one-dimensional soundboard for May and Nick Bannister. His presence in the film was truly wasted and definitely a missed opportunity. Hugh Jackman is one of my favorite actors. I enjoyed him in every Wolverine X-Men film. When Jackman played Nick Bannister, happens to be a murmur of the aforesaid line about past haunting powers, he delivers it through a Morse voiceover, one of the many granting over diligence of a Reminisce introducing his unconventional professionalism to the viewer in the film's opening moment. I don't think this was Hugh Jackman's best role. The cast is talented, it's just the directing and the script was lacking. Honestly, let Hugh Jackman create the Nick Bannister. He's good at making Wolverine, so I know he would definitely do it on his own, but I know he couldn't because they had to listen to what the director said. And of course, sticks to the script as well too. So that's all I gotta say. Y'all, let's briefly talk about the cinematography and the visual effects. I was really impressed. I like how they made the trains kind of like traveling in the water. That was really cool. The atmosphere and as well the device that was used in the film that makes you see people's past. That was pretty cool. Oh, also the music score is fantastic. Composer Ramin Djawadi, whom those in the music world will know him from the Game of Thrones, but this music adds a little impact to the film, which is pretty cool. And perhaps the greatest crime of Reminisce is how effortlessly it wastes the collective appeal of an A-list cast. In the aftermath, you will be hard to pressed to recall whether Bannister was played by a bona fide movie star or an unthinkable newcomer. Joy has a wealth of stylistic and thematic ideas to spare. Let's hope that she keeps taking risks and making feature-length movies. This is her first film, and obviously, when people make their first film, there's always mistakes, and it's perfectly fine, it's natural. So I hope that she takes the constructive criticism and probably next time, you know, make the film more awesome. She's married to one of the Nolan brothers, one of them who directed the Batman film, Dark Knight, and Dark Knight Rises Again, I believe, yes. So hopefully she'll definitely learn from them and this time make a, as I said earlier, a spectacular film. And I know she will. We gotta give up and coming directors a chance. Obviously the first film, as I said, is going to, not gonna be the best, but it'll get better and better each time. But I will say for this film in particular, the rumination on the assortment the genres unfortunately sinks under its own weight. However, I had a great time watching this movie, and seriously, can you imagine if there was a machine like that where they can actually see your past life? That'd be so crazy. You never know. The future of technology is endless. I give Reminisce 3 stars. And what you guys think about the movie, let me know in the comments below. I'm your host, Anika Chung, and I'll see you next time on my next motion picture or trailer review. Love yourself always, and remember, be excellent to each other. Alright guys, see you in the next pictures. Cheers!
Nothing left to say. Beauty and the Beast.